Hello everyone. Welcome to another video in the series on mastering data structures and algorithms. I'm Dr. Prashant K. Gupta. In the previous two videos, we have introduced the arrays, created the arrays and inserted values into them. In the introductory video on the arrays, we considered very simple cases in which the array was created and insertion of the values was done at the end of the array. Further, we also discussed their algorithms. And in my last video, I explained through a step-by-step example on how to insert values in an array in the case 2. That is, the array was in sorted order and the value was required to be inserted into the array by keeping that sorted order. The topic of this video is to insert the element into an array at an appropriate position, however that position is already given to us. Therefore, it does not matter whether the array is in sorted order or not. Ideally, just we have to take particular event of the array and insert it to the position and preserve other elements from getting lost. So let's see how this is done. This is a brief introduction about myself. I'm Dr. Prashanti Gupta. There's a link to my website. You can visit my website and have a look on what international visits I have been to, what publications I have produced till date, what all syllabus I have designed, and what is my current role. By passion, I am a researcher and also a faculty. So this is the topic of this video, that is inserting value into the array in the case number 3. What is case number 3? I strongly advise you to go and visit the introductory video on arrays. This is the algorithm that we had discussed in that introductory video. Here A is the array that needs to be operated on. N is the number of elements that are currently stored in the array. The value of N is less than equal to max, where max is defined using a macro. And its value depicts what is the maximum number of elements that can be stored in an array. Item is that element that needs to be inserted in an array. And PO is the position at which item needs to be inserted. I we have used as some random variable in our program. Any other variable can also be used. So let us assume over here that the array elements are 11, 2, 77, 8, and 9. Now, can you clearly see that yes, elements are not necessarily in any sorted order. However, n is 5. That is the number of elements is 5. And max we have defined as 10. Let the item to be inserted is 4. And the position at which it needs to be inserted is the fourth position. Now, this is a very important point that is mentioned in the bracket next to it, that it will be taken as 3 since the index goes from 0 to n minus 1. Why? Because you are doing C programming. And in C programming, the index goes from 0 to n minus 1. So now you can see index goes from 0 to 4. Now, as soon as we enter the program, the first statement is executed. The value of I is made as n minus 1, that is 5 minus 1, which equals to 4, because it must point to the last index. And the value of POS is 3, that is the position at which element needs to be inserted, which is the item in this case. Now the second statement is executed and the check is performed if the value of I is greater than or equal to position, which is the case over here exactly. The value of I is 4, it is greater than the position, that is 3. Therefore, the statement inside the loop are executed. The array at index I plus 1 gets the value of I, that is A of I plus 1, that is equals to 5, and A of I is 4. So therefore A5 gets the value of A, and therefore A5 becomes 9. And the value of I is decremented. So you can actually see the result of executing this statement. That is, now the value of the array in the index number 4 is copied into the index number 5. And this statement is executed and the value of I is decremented. It is made as 3. Therefore, now the index I will shift one position to the left. So again, the statement is checked while I is greater than or equal to position. Now you can clearly see that I is 3, which equals to the position. So the test is true. Therefore, the statements inside the loop are executed. A4 gets the value 8 and I is decremented. And therefore, now you can see from the diagram above, the value of A4 gets the same value as A3. And the value of I got decremented, and now I points to the index 2. Now again, the condition, the loop is checked. However, over here, the value of I is 2, which is less than the value of the position, that is. Therefore, the test fails and the loop exits. Therefore, A of POS, that is A3, gets the value of the item that needs to be inserted. Therefore, now our array becomes like this, where the value 4 gets inserted at the appropriate position. And the value of n becomes 5 plus 1, that is 6, because now the array has 6 elements. Therefore, what is the final array? Yes, you have guessed it right. It is 11, 2, 77, 4, 8, and 9. Therefore, I thank you all for watching this video. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel, because more and more good videos will be coming up. Thank you and have a nice day.